What classes do you teach here at Harvest Church?
Oh, we teach the kindergarten class, which is ages 3 through 6. Wonderful age. Love those kids. They're amazing.
All right, Sister Barbara, what is your favorite Bible story?
That's a hard one because I have a lot. I mean, a lot of favorites. But I think out of the Old Testament, my favorite would be Noah and his ark with all the animals. Because I love animals anyway, and all the animals coming in. God shut the door. It never rained before, and it flooded. And the New Testament, I would say Jesus feeding the 5,000 with a little boy's lunch.
That was an amazing story.
Just a few bread, fish, and then they took up 12 baskets left over. That's a miracle, really. That's a miracle.
Well, thank you, Sister Barbara, for coming and talking with us.
Thank you so much, Reverend Wiggins.
Thank you.
This has been Interviews with Reverend Wiggins. Join us next time as we interview Sister Shayla.
Welcome back. This is our Friday devotion time. It's on page 13. We just finished up talk time. So our talk time tonight was basically, we're talking to our parents about what is something that we have made that we thought was good. Now, Brother Justin had something he made one time. I had the help of my parents, though, so I'm not going to say it was just me. But it was something I was very proud of. See, in fifth grade, we had this awesome thing that we had to make. We had to make the earth with, like, all the different layers on the inside of it. Well, my dad helped me out. He got me a golf ball that was painted like the earth, and we cut it in half. I got to draw all the cool little stuff on the inside, and we put that golf ball on a tee, and we made for that golf ball an open and close, and it was like on this grassy little hill that would show the earth as if it was a golf ball, but yet it was still my science project showing all the layers of the earth on the inside. See, that was something I was proud of. It got displayed in the school for like a couple of months, and then when I finally got to bring it home, it was just something I was totally proud of that all that hard work I put into it, and someone loved it. See, my creation that I had made, that cool project, that was something that, you know, I was able to do some of it or most of it, but my mom and dad had to help me. There's all these great things that God has made for us, and guess what? He did it all on his own. We all these great things around us, this creation, like I said, that we get to enjoy. God did all of this on his own. He took a week to make all these awesome things. Sister Shayla on Tuesday night talked about how she tried to use Play-Doh just to make one item, and it was hard. It took her a couple of minutes and she couldn't make it nowhere near what God did. But it's just amazing what all God can do. So let's pray tonight. Let's pray for the parts of creation that we can control. Let's pray that we understand what God has done for us. Let's all pray together. God, I thank you, Lord, for all that you do, Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this creation that you've given us, God. All of these wonderful things, all the animals, the plants, our church, all the people that surround us, Jesus. Lord, everything, the sky, the sun, the moon, the stars, everything that is so beautiful that's around us that we see every day is something that you have placed your hand upon, that you created. And we thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. So we've got to enjoy all this week. I hope you got to go outside today or even yesterday whenever we talked about challenging. We challenged you guys to go outside or do something to enjoy God's creation. We hope you got to do that. If you didn't, you still have time. We still have today and tomorrow before Sunday, before we start our next item. But make sure that you are enjoying God's creation. Don't forget, our life lesson is, I will enjoy being with God in his wonderful creation.